Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October 21st of 2021, well, it is titled SH2-308, the Dolphin Head Nebula. So what do we see here? Well, this is a nebula that is known as the Dolphin Head Nebula for its distinctive shape and the kind of pointed head of a dolphin pointing out towards the upper left hand side. And this is a nebula that is associated with a young star that has formed, and it is called a Wolf-Rayet star. These are very massive stars and stars that do not live for a very long time. And they are unstable and have pushed out material. So we're seeing some of the material pushed out away from this star as it expands out to cover a distance of 60 light years in diameter. So that's about 60 light years across. Now it expands out not uniformly because the interstellar media around it is not uniform. There are areas where it is denser and the material has not had a chance to move as far. And you can see that towards the upper right hand side where everything is kind of condensed together and there's more of a shock there. Whereas where we see the head of the dolphin or the mouth of the dolphin off to the upper left, it's had more of an area to expand. So an opening within the interstellar medium has allowed material to be able to escape out there. Now, this is a looking at the image of oxygen atoms. So oxygen atoms, which have been ionized and have been colored in blue for us to be able to see. So that is a good way to look at nebulae, because gaseous nebulae like these give off very specific wavelengths of light, and they emit wavelengths based on the materials from which they are composed. Now, well, this would also be mostly hydrogen, but there is a good chance to review it and study it in the oxygen as well. So we can use that to kind of map out the structures and allow us to see more detail by focusing on that narrow band image, the specific wavelengths that the emission is occurring in. So instead of looking across the whole electromagnetic spectrum, we focus it and look at just those specific wavelengths. We often do this with hydrogen, but we can also do it, as we see here, with oxygen. Now this nebula is about 70,000 years old, and the star is the type that we expect will eventually become a supernova. And that means that it will explode and destroy the entire nebula as the shockwave expands out through it at some point in the future. Now, when that will occur is a good question, and we don't know, because we cannot see within the star. We can see the star itself, the brighter star towards the center, but we cannot see what is going on in the interior. And it is when the interior becomes unstable that the star will explode. But we have no idea whether that would be 20,000, 100,000, or a million years from now. So it still has some time to go, but exactly how long is something we can't see and will not know until that day comes. So that was our picture of the day for October the 21st of 2021. It was titled SH2-308, the Dolphin Head Nebula. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be It's a Comet. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.